And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this infinity loop in PowerPoint 2016. As you can see that we have three slides here, and let me explain you the animation before we dig into the tutorial. As you can see that this is the first presentation on which the infinity loop animation making one round and then stop it there. On the second slide you can see that it will repeat itself two times very smoothly and will then stop. So on the first slide you can see that this liquid form is moving and then stop and then get contract. And on the second slide you can see that it is making two rounds and will then stop there. And on the third slide you might have a guess that what I am doing to accomplish this tutorial, and that is the important part which you are going to learn in this tutorial, that how you can do a little bit kind of masking in PowerPoint 2016, so you can make these kind of animation by yourself. As you can see that these boxes are showing and hiding themselves two times in the animation, and that is because of those boxes this animation is possible to create in PowerPoint 2016. So before I start teaching you that, let me tell you that this animation is inspired from one of the animation by Twiki 2, and I would like you, if you can make these kind of presentation, like after learning this infinity loop animation in PowerPoint 2016, if you can make this kind of animation and then you can post that video link into the comment section, and I will definitely show off that video in my next tutorial. So let's get started. Let me take a new presentation by clicking on file menu, then click new and then choose blank presentation. Collapse the thumbnail view and from the layout drop down button choose blank. And as you can see that I have already turned on guides, and if you want to then go to the view tab and click on guides. Now go to the insert tab, click shapes drop down button and choose teardrop shape and just click inside the presentation. Now I want to increase the size, and the easiest way is to hold down the control alt and shift keys to increase the size simultaneously from all the sides. Now go to the rotate drop down button from the format tab and click on more rotation options, and from the size and properties window change the rotation to 45 degrees. Hit the enter key, collapse this format shape dialog box. Now go to the align, click center and then click align again, and this time middle. Make a duplicate of this shape here. From the home tab click copy and paste, or you can select the shape, can press Ctrl T, or you can also hold down Ctrl and shift keys and then just drag and drop this shape like that. Now if you are doing in the third way, then again hold down the shift key and drag and drop this shape back to the previous one. Now hold down Ctrl Alt and shift keys while reducing the size. And if you don't want to get confused with the colors, so I will change the color of the top object. From the format tab click shape fill and choose any other color. Now select this shape and both of these shapes and make a duplicate. Now go to the format tab, click rotate and use flip horizontally. Now select all of these objects on the slide by hitting Ctrl A and then just drag and drop them. So as I now want to align both of these objects to the center and the middle of the slide, so what I can do here, press the Ctrl A key, go to the format tab, click group drop down button and choose group. Now align center and align middle, and later you can ungroup them. Now the next thing we will do is to make a duplicate of all of these four objects by hitting the Ctrl A key and then drag and drop on the top. So why I am doing this, let me show you that. On these four objects I will use the command from the format tab, merge shapes, fragment. For the top objects, select one of these two objects by holding the shift key and go to the merge shapes and choose combine command, and for these two do the same. Now adjust the position of these two right here, and now I will make them a union. Okay, now what you have to do, align this to the center and the middle of the slide, right, like that, and then delete the rest of these, and you have these four boxes. Let me send this to the back. Now adjust these four boxes like that, one here, one right there, one is already there, and fourth one right here. So the next thing is, we will draw a rectangle, a full slide rectangle, and send it to back. Now hold down the shift key and select this shape, the union shape, and go to merge shapes and then choose command subtract. Now we have our main design ready. So next thing is to draw a shape, and that will be an oval, and just click inside the presentation, that will draw a default 1x1 size oval here. And now just drag and drop this oval right here in the middle. Change the color as you like and remove the outline by clicking on shape outline, no outline. Now the next thing is to animate this oval here, and you can use any shape if you like, but I think oval will be the best. Now I will select this oval and will animate it inside the infinity loop symbol. Select the oval, go to the animations tab, and this time I will apply a motion path to this oval, but instead of applying the motion path from the add animation drop down button, I will go to the animation drop down list, and here you can find the custom path which is not available in add animation drop down list. So that is why I am clicking here and choose this time custom path. You can either draw the path like this in straight lines by making points here, and as many points you will draw, the smoother will be the animation. Or later you can click on effect options and can choose edit points to make adjustment. Like you can right click on a point and then can delete or make it a smooth point as you like. So instead of doing that, let me undo this. Select the oval, go to the animations, open the animation drop down list and choose custom path. And before start drawing your path here in the infinity loop symbol, go to the effect options and then choose curve, and now start drawing the path. That will make it more in curve shape, and the animation will look more realistic. Add as many points you want to by just clicking the left mouse button, and I will combine it with the starting point. So here we have our main animation, and later if you want to edit the points, go to the effect option and click edit points, and same way you can right click on a point and can choose various options as you like. And if you think that path is fine here, then set it to play with previous, and I would like a rotation of 4 seconds. Open the animation pan, double click to open the effect options window and remove the smoothness. Hit the OK key. Now what you have to do, select this oval, go to the format tab and send it to the back. Now it will look like a liquid shape moving around. So if you want to make this liquid form a little bit larger, then what you can do, select this oval, make a duplicate, adjust it on the top, and these four guides will tell you that the position is exactly matching with the previous one. And now what you have to do, you have to add a delay timing, and I will go with 0.05. Hit the enter key, and if you want to make the tail more longer, then start making duplicates, just them on top, and just add a delay timing of 0.5 seconds. Do that as many times you want. I will use 4 or 5. One more. Okay. Now select all these ovals like this and send them to the back. Now let's see the animation. Okay. So the next thing is, I want, if I hide these objects, these four square hairs, let me open the selection pane, and here we have these four squares. Sorry. Now see the animation again, and you will see the full oval at this point right here in the cross section. So that is not what I want to show to the viewers, and that is why we will use the masking kind of thing in PowerPoint, and for that I have used these four boxes. These are grouped together. I think one is missing. I think this object is combined with this one. So I will delete this and make a duplicate of this right here. And okay, now we have the four squares here. So what we have to do, what I want here is, when this liquid shape get right here, I want these two squares to disappear. And for that, what I will do, select both of these squares, go to the animations, add animation, and apply the disappear animation. Set it to play with previous, and now you have to adjust the delay timing. And as we have 4 second duration of for this total animation, so what I would like to do is to hide these two squares in the beginning. Let me set it to 0, because we don't need them right in the beginning of this animation. Now, and later you have to hide these two squares here, and for the same I will use the disappear command and will adjust the delay timing, and that will be around, I think, at 2 seconds. I would like to disappear them, make them disappear. Let me show you the animation. Okay, that's fine. So the next thing is, I want to make these two squares appear at what time. Let me show you the animation again. When this liquid form move right from here, cross from here. So for that, I will apply add animation appear with previous, and this time I will set a delay timing of 2. Let me test it with the 2 seconds. That's fine. Okay, so the last thing is to hide these squares with using the same colors as of the behind objects, and remove the outline. I think, okay, let me select them again. Select these squares and set the color to white and remove the outline. Now let's see the final animation. Okay, the size of the square is a bit larger, so I will reduce them manually, or let me set this outline to white. Let's see the preview again. Okay, I think that's fine. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. And don't forget to hit the like button and do share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and take care.